In this video, we're continuing on with the Mixture Word Problems worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. You can find this worksheet under the Algebra 2 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Picking up with number 5, it asks, how many gallons of a 65% saline solution must be mixed with 8 gallons of pure water to make a 25% solution? So we have to figure out how many gallons of a 65% saline solution must be mixed with 8 gallons of pure water to make a 25% solution. So unlike numbers 1 through 4, where we were finding the concentration of the final solution, we're given it in this case, which is 25%. So we have to find out how many gallons X of the 65% saline solution must be mixed. We're going to start by figuring out the amount of saline in the mixture. That's going to be X times 0.65. When we convert 65% to a decimal, that's 0.65. And we're going to add that to 8 gallons times the percentage of saline, which if it's pure water, it's 0% saline. So 8 times 0. So the amount of saline in the mixture gets divided by the total amount or the total volume of the mixture, which is X plus 8. And that is going to be equal to the concentration, but in decimal form, so 0.25. Now we're just going to solve for X. In order to do that, we have to get this X plus 8 out of the denominator in order to get the X out of the denominator. So we're going to multiply everything by X plus 8. Whatever I do to the left, I need to do to the right. So X plus 8 in the denominator will cancel out with X plus 8 in the numerator, and I will distribute my 0.25. So X times 0.65 will be 0.65X, and I'm adding that to 8 times 0, which is 0. So all I have on my left is 0.65X, and that's going to be equal to 0.25X plus 0.25 times 8, which is 2. Now I'm going to move similar terms to the same side of the equation. So I'm going to subtract by 0.25x. 0.65x minus 0.25x will give me 0.4x, and that's going to be equal to 2. Now all I have to do is divide by 0.4. When I divide by 0.4, I get that x is equal to 2 divided by 0.4, which is 5. And X is a volume, which is gallons, so X is equal to 5 gallons. Now let's move on to number 6. In number 6, it says 1 ounce of walnuts were mixed with 4 ounces of peanuts, which cost $4 per ounce to make. So the peanuts cost $4 per ounce. So the 4 ounces of peanuts cost $4 per ounce, and the total mixture is $5. So what we're trying to figure out is what is the price per ounce of walnuts, given that there's 1 ounce of walnuts in the entire mixture. So we have 1 ounce of walnuts, and we're multiplying it by our variable. Let's call our variable y, which is the price per ounce. So 1 times y plus 4 ounces of peanuts, which cost $4 per ounce to make. So 4 times 4. That will be the total cost of the mixture. So taking the total cost of the mixture and dividing it by the total weight, 4 ounces plus 1 ounce, so 1 plus 4, we will get the price per ounce of the entire mixture, which we know is $5 per ounce. So again, I take the total cost of the entire mixture divided by the total number of ounces in the mixture to get the price per ounce of the mixture. But what we're looking for is this y, the price per ounce of walnuts. So let's go ahead and solve for y. Simplifying this, 1 times y is simply y, and we're adding that to 4 times 4, which is 16, and that gets divided by 1 plus 4, which is 5, and that's equal to $5 per ounce, so 5. My next step, I'm going to multiply both sides by 5 in order to remove the 5 from the denominator. I'll be left with y plus 16 equal to 25. my last step will be to subtract 16 from both sides. And doing that, I'll get that y is equal to 25 minus 16, which is 9, and y represents the price per ounce of walnuts, so this is $9 per ounce. So if I was to plug 9 back in for y and solve, 9 plus 16 is 25 divided by 5 does indeed equals 5, and that's $5 per ounce. So the price per ounce of walnuts is $9 per ounce. Let's move on to number 7. Number 7 says that Heather wants to make a 36% acid solution. So that's the total concentration of the entire solution. She already has poured 3 fluid ounces of a 72% acid solution into the beaker. So we're trying to figure out how many fluid ounces of a 9% acid solution must she add to this to create that desired mixture, which is a 36% concentration. So we're going to have 3 ounces of a 72% concentration, so 3 times 0.72. We're going to add that to our variable, how many fluid ounces of the 9% acid solution. So let's call this variable x. So that's going to be added to x, how many fluid ounces of the other solution she adds, which is a 9% concentration. So we're multiplying x by 0.09%. So 3 times 0.72 plus x times 0.09 will give us the total amount of acid in the new mixture. And in order to calculate the concentration, we're going to divide that by the total ounces in the new mixture, which is 3 plus x. And that is all equal to her desired concentration of 36%, so 0.36. Now we're just going to solve for x. We need to move this 3 plus x out of the denominator, so we're going to multiply both sides by 3 plus x. I'm doing this, my 3 plus x will cancel out, so I'll have 3 times 0.72, which is 2.16. I'm adding that to x times 0.09, so 0.09x, and that's going to equal 0.36 distributed to the 3, and then distributed to the x with addition in between those two terms. 0.36 times 3 is 1.08, and I'm adding that to 0.36x. My next step, I'm going to move the terms with x to the right-hand side of my equation. So I'm going to subtract 0.09x from both sides. That will give me 2.16 on my left equal to 1.08 plus 0.36 minus 0.09, which is 0.27x. Now I'm going to move the terms without x to the left side to get that term with the x by itself. So I'm going to subtract 1.08 from both sides. 2.16 minus 1.08 is equal to a positive 1.08, and that is equal to 0.27x. since 1.08 minus 1.08 is 0. Now my last step is to divide by 0.27. 1.08 divided by 0.27 will give me 4. And that's going to be 4 fluid ounces. So 4 fluid ounces is the number of ounces she must have of that 9% acid solution in order to have a total concentration of 36%. Now finally, on to number 8. Callie mixed together 9 gallons of brand A fruit drink and 6 gallons of brand B fruit drink, and that brand B contained 5% juice. Find the percent of fruit juice in brand A, so the percentage of those 9 gallons, if the total mixture contained 11% fruit juice. So we're going to have 9 gallons, and we're going to multiply that by our variable, which is the percent of fruit juice in brand A. Let's go ahead and make this variable Z. So 9 gallons times Z will give us the amount of fruit juice in the 9 gallons of brand A, and we're adding that to the amount of fruit juice in 6 gallons of brand B, which is 5% fruit juice, so 6 times 0.05 will give us that amount. We have to divide this by the total amount of gallons in the entire mixture, which is 9 gallons plus 6 gallons. And the concentration of the total mixture is 11%, so 0.11. Now all I have to do is solve for z. Let's simplify first. 9 times z is 9z, and I'm adding that to 6 times 0.05, which is 0.3. And that is divided by 9 plus 6, which is 15. And this is all equal to 0.11. My next step, I'm going to multiply both sides by 15. When I multiply both sides by 15, my 15s will cancel out. So I'll have 9z plus 0.3 equal to 0.11 times 15, which is 1.65. Next, I'll subtract 0.3 from both sides. On my left, I'll have 9z, and on my right, 1.65 minus 0.3 equals 1.35. My last and final step is to divide both sides by 9. My 9s will cancel out on the left, and I'll have z equal to 1.35 divided by 9, which is 0.15, which is equal to 15%. So z, the percent of fruit juice in brand A, is 15%. I'll stop the video here. Join me in the next video where I'll complete this worksheet, working out the answers for numbers 9 through 12. Before you continue on to that, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below.